So as you likely know, some of the board members on those boards of health have expressed, disbelief about COVID-19. Some of them have flat out said they don't believe that COVID-19 is an urgent problem. Meanwhile, you have, of course, repeatedly acknowledged that this virus is indeed a problem and needs to be taken seriously. Do you have concern about some of the decisions being left to the local district when there is a very real possibility that some of these boards may not mandate anything? So I guess, how confident are you that these boards of health will take action if action is needed?
Well, I know I've said at this podium, never say never, never say always. But that's, for 50 years, that's been how we've administered public health in the state of Idaho. And I stole it from somebody, but I can't remember who. The key part of public health is public. And those, for the most part, 80% of all the members of the health districts, I'll see if Elke will give me a head nod if that's correct, 80% of them are elected. They're county commissioners, they're all required to have one medical person on their board, but they're selected by the rest of them. But they represent the public, just like the legislative branch and the county commissioners represent the public. So I am fully committed to do all I can to give them all the tools, the resources, the advice, and the counsel for them to look at the data that we have and make the right decision. And we actually have 1, 2, 3 health districts that have mandates. Yeah, 3 health districts out of the 7 that have mandates, and the remainder 4 have also got strong suggestions and advice out there. So we're getting there. We've got a couple areas where I'd like to get there a little faster.